guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother howdy.
Make it our aim For we must all be made manifest before the judgment seat of Christ, that each one may receive the things done in the body according to what he has done. Are bad, but I am ready to be offered up, and the time of my departure, he is at hand. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give to me at that day. And not to me only, but also to all them that have loved his appearing. Wherefore, girding up the lines of your minds, be sober and set your hope perfectly on the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. As children of obedience, not fashioning yourselves according to your former lusts in the time of your ignorance, but like as he was who called you in holiness, holy, be ye yourselves also holy in all manner of living. Because it is written, ye shall be holy, for I am holy. And if you call on him as Father, without respect of persons, judges according to each man's work, past the time of your sojourn. Thank you. brothers and sisters, we come together this time, which is a sad day, but the joy is knowing that our dear brother is in a better place, knowing that our dear brother is in a better place. Amen. The family has made out a program in which we ask that everyone would respect. Amen. We will have a selection by Antioch Baptist Church, Prayer of Comfort by Deacon Dennis McGriff, Scripture, Minister Johnson, a poem, Brianna Worth, and Reflections by Deacon Joe Jones and Mrs. Natasha Cooper, a music selection, Brother Larry Brown, and we'll proceed from there with the eulogy. At this time, a selection from the choir.
Gotta be saint and saints abide.
Deacon Dennis McGriff would come. Give us a prayer of comfort. Most Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, Father, with bowed down heads as humble as we know how, Father. Father God, we come before you right now, Father, even though it's a sad time, Father, but we still just want to tell you thank you. Father God, we realize, Father, that you're still in control, Father. Father God, we just ask you for us right now, Father, to continue to bless us, Father. Father God, I ask you to pray for your blessing over the Reed family, Father. Father God, you are a doctor that can heal broken hearts, Father. Father God, you can drive teary eyes, Father. Father God, I ask you just continue to be with them, Father. Father God, help them in their healing process, Father. Father God, keep in mind the eyes on you, Father. Father God, we realize that your will is going to be done on earth as it is done in heaven, Father. Father God, we realize, Father, we're all traveling down this Christian journey, Father. We realize one of these days, Father, we must have something to do, Father. Father God, when that day comes, Father, we ask that you give us a home somewhere in your kingdom, Father, that we may praise you better than we do now, Father. Father God, we ask you these blessings in your Son, Jesus' name. I do pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Minister Alonzo. Amen. Johnson. Yeah. Amen. Praise the Lord today. We're going to come with you two scriptures, one from the Old Testament and one from the New Testament. We're going to be coming from Psalms 121 out of the Old Testament. I will lift up my eyes to the hills, from which cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keepeth you will not slumber. Behold, he who keepeth Israel shall not slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve you, your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and even more. Now we'll be going, praise God, to the New Testament. 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 and 14. And the scripture reads, "But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who fall asleep, lest ye sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus." Yeah. Praise God for the reading of the word.
Amen. Father and sister, Brianna Worth, granddaughter. Amen.
For me now, I'm free. I'm following the path God laid for me. I took his hand when I heard him call. I turned my back and left it all. I could not stay another day to laugh, to love, to work, or play. Tasks left undone must stay that way. I found that peace at the close of day. If my parting has left a void, then fill it with remembered joy. A friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss. Yes, these things I too will miss. Me not burdened with times of sorrow. I wish you the sunshine of tomorrow. My life's been full, I've savored much. Good times, good friends, a loved one's touch. Perhaps my time seemed all too brief. Don't lengthen it now with undue grief. Lift up your heart and share with me. God wanted me now, he set me free.
Praise the Lord. God is good all the time. Amen. We have reflections from friend, co-worker, Deacon Joe Jones. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. John Henry Hawkins, my friend, my childhood friend. I guess we go back some 57 years ago. You know, I was standing there and it take me 2 or 3 days to tell you about me and John. That's how close we were. But I'm going to be obedient to John. Me and John started out as being childhood friends. We stayed next door to each other and we were born. He moved around the corner from us, and we lived on the same street again. And we had a lot in common. He loved sports, I did too. He loved the basketball, he loved the football, so did I. We grew up participating in all kinds of sports. He was a year older than I was, and I remember when he got his first vehicle. A lot of y'all don't know about the electric 225. Better known as a deuce and a quarter. That big bird car that was bigger than a Cadillac. We used to cruise America summertime all over town in that car. I left, moved to Atlanta. I came back shortly, me and John took up. But we left out there. You know, I went to him one day and said, John, I need a job. Y'all ain't hiring? I said, you the man, I got the plan. Get me on. That was on a Monday. That Wednesday, he told me, you ready to go to work tomorrow? You know, doing what a friend would do for a friend, you know.
Yes.
And we worked there a little while and we both moved on to a bigger and better plan. Well, we made good money. And for 20 years, he drove forklift and I was a line coordinator. When he wasn't busy, he'd be over my area. A lot of people thought we were brothers. You know, when I had a moment, I'd be in his area. And we shared a lot of good times. I remember when all of his kids were born. I don't think there's a Hawkins here that don't know me. We had that uncanny love for each other. He would tell people quick, Joe Jones is a good man. And that's what I liked about John. He also was a good man, you know. John was multi-talented. You know, he could cut hair. You know, he could bone. You know, he could cut grass. You know, he was good at a lot of things. And I never once called him, but he didn't come see about him. And not once did he meet me that I didn't go and see about him. I thank the Lord for that cohesiveness that stuck me and John together for about 57 years. This is one of my dearest friends. And I know one day we'll see each other again. I can only say to the family, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not into your own understanding. And all thy way of knowledge, Lord, we shall direct your path. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Mrs. Natasha Cooper, family member.
How everybody doing? I know it's not a good occasion, but I come
couldn't get nobody else to come right here, so I said I'd go on and do it. My name is Tasha, and I'm his oldest daughter. I love to talk back, so I'm just going to be real. My father, he was a good man. We love him very dearly. And whatever he can call us and talk to us, we did. Sometimes I avoid the phone calls now, but my father was one of the ones that could sit on the phone and could hold the phone and talk so slow that you'd be like, oh my God. I'll call him back at another time because I know he talked very, 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 very slow. But he was a good man. And I just want to tell the family, y'all, keep y'all here. He is in a better place. He loves us all, and I know he loves us all. And we just got to stay prayed up. And I just want to tell y'all that.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Years ago, selection, Brother Larry Brown, if you would come, please. Present to us songs of praise. Amen. And as we kneel down to pray, we ask the Lord to keep us strong, Lord, Lord, and forgive us for all of wrong. Yes, let me walk down the street that's paved with gold. Yes, Jesus and me. There'll be times I may stumble along the way. Oh, yeah, yeah. Disobeying against time, and my soul needs rest. But what we do wrong? If I over. When I'm done, my love. Regardless of what I'm going through, that everything gonna be all right. Amen to this wonderful and beautiful family, to the wife and children. We want to tell you to look to the hills, from which cometh your help. All your help comes from the Lord. And I want you to know something, that Deacon Hawkins knew that. That's why he professed the faith in the Lord Jesus Christ a long time ago and became a disciple of Jesus Christ, because he knew that one day, amen, the roll would be called and he would have to answer, just like all of us, each one of us. One of these days, we don't know how God is going to do it. Yeah, we might be driving in our cars, we don't know how God is going to do it. You might be sleeping in your bed, you don't know how God is going to do it. But one of these days, all of us will have to make that transition. And the good thing is knowing that your father, your husband, was saved. Amen. Amen. We're not going to bother you long. We're going to give you a portion of a scripture here and speak a few words of comfort to the family. This is a time, amen, that the family need comfort. Amen, somebody. You know, sometimes we go back and try to find all the bad things, but this is a time that the family, somebody say family, needs comfort. Amen, somebody. The family needs comfort, and this is a good family, and you had a good father. Amen. We're going to bring you a word from what a preacher wrote in Ecclesiastes. He said, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the sun. Ecclesiastes 3:1. To everything there is a season and a purpose under the sun. I want to encourage you, dear family and friends, to do what you can while you can. Do what you can while you can. While the blood is running warm in your veins, do what you can while you can. If Deacon Hawkins was here today, he would encourage you to serve the Lord. Amen. To serve the Lord. To look to him. To trust in the Lord with all their heart and lead not to their own understanding. In all their ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. Amen. Look to God. Nobody else. Sister Hawkins, to the daughters and sons of Deacon Hawkins. Nobody can be with you 24/7. Nobody can be with you weeks and months from now when you reflect on the goodness and the memories of your father. Nobody but Jesus. Nobody but him. And he will be there, the Bible said, even until the end of the world. Yeah, nothing. My friend, my sisters, my brothers, can separate us from the love of God. Nothing, the Bible says, nothing can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Jesus, because that he went in the grave and he came out resurrected, it gives us a reason to hope, a reason to know that life does not end at death. Yes, because he lives, because Jesus lives, I can face tomorrow. Because Jesus lives, amen, I will be able to say, as the scripture said, that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Amen. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. So remember, my brothers and my sisters, remember the good times. Amen. I remember Deacon Hawkins as he came and joined Antioch Baptist Church. Amen. As a deacon, he brought all his gifts with him. Amen. All of his gifts. He did what he could while he brought all his gifts. Amen. And I didn't know that he could sing, but he would get up there and sing hymnals. Amen, somebody. I did not know that Deacon Hawkins could sing. Somebody say amen. Amen. But he did what he could do. He would come in, amen, and he would go up front and he would sing hymns. I mean, he sung so well that it made me think that I could sing. And everybody that know me know I can't sing. Come on, somebody. But Deacon Hawkins, he would ease up there, amen, in his own spirit, and he would begin to sing hymns. And I said, my Lord, I got to do better. I got to do better. I got to do better. Amen. And he would get up there, and he would sing, and he would praise God through prayers. He would pray. He was a praying man. Yes, he was. He was a praying man. Amen. He was a praying man, and he was a singing man, and he loved his children, and he loved his wife. I don't know too many men like Deacon Hawkins. Yeah. Get up in the morning, cook some breakfast. Come on, somebody. Yeah, he would get up and he would cook some breakfast. Amen. And it turned out pretty good, then this is all. It turned out pretty good, didn't it? He would cook some breakfast. Amen. That's another thing I can't do unless I burn up everything. I won't even try. But he would cook breakfast. Amen. And he knew how to cook dinner. Amen. Not too many men, amen, can do that. Not too many men can do like Deacon Hawkins did. He would sit there sometime on Sunday morning and look like pain would be racking his body. Yeah. But he'll get up real slow or real easy. And he would clap his hands. Amen. He would clap his hands. So we have to do church, children, family members, friends. We have to do what we can while we can. He fought a good fight. He was a fighter. Amen. Yeah. He wasn't a home wrecker. He was a fighter. Amen. He fought. Yeah. He fought to the very end. He fought a good fight. And he finished his course. He did what he could while he could. And many of us need to do the same thing. You may not be gifted to sing, or you may not be gifted with all these other things, but you got something. Amen, somebody. You got something you can offer to the Lord. And Deacon Hawkins gave what he had to the Lord. Amen. But there is a time. Amen. There's a time. There's a time. There's a time for everything under the sun. Everything. There's a season. Yeah. Some of these gentlemen in here that's senior citizens would tell you that they went from 16 to senior citizen overnight. Come on, somebody. Yeah. Yeah. Went from 16 to senior citizen overnight. Amen. Yeah. They don't have that jump like they used to have. I don't have it either. I got my little legs and back problems, knee problems and all that. I can't spring like I used to spring. Used to just run and jump, lift weights, flip, and all of these things. But time. All right? But time brings on a change. Yeah. You can remember when, but you know you can't do what you used to do the way that you used to do it. So you have to do what you can while you're able to do it. To everything that is a season. Yeah. Sometimes we miss our seasons because we're not focused on the Lord. Look to the hill from which cometh your help. All of your help come from the Lord, which created the heaven and earth. Look to Jesus. Amen. He's the only one that can help you in times like these. Get involved with a church somewhere so you can exercise your gifts. And you'll be able to say, may the works that I've done speak for me. Everything. There is a season and a time to every purpose under the sun. I tell you, my brothers and my sisters, that Deacon Hawkins is in a better place. We have to wear all these masks, double masks. Amen. Washing your hand every time you look around. And all of this. Social distancing. Can't hug like you used to hug. I miss hugging people. Amen. But you just can't do it like that anymore. Yeah, you can't do it like that anymore. So you do what you can so that when the time comes, amen, for one of your loved ones, and God called the roll, we'll be able to say that we had our talk. That young lady said they used to talk. Uh-huh. Yeah, they used to talk. It's good for you to reach out to your loved ones right now. Yeah, talk to them. Love on them. No matter what you got had against them, forgive them. Amen. Time is short. Time is winding up. Forgive them. Make that telephone call and let your loved ones know that you love them. Make it. Forget about those things that are behind and press forward, amen, towards the Lord in Jesus Christ. Yeah. Love them while you can. Tell them that you love them while you can. while they can hear. Tell them that you love them. Tell them that you want to talk with them. Tell them that you appreciate them while you can. Amen. Tell them, brothers and sisters, daughters and sons of Deacon Hawkins, tell one another you love one another. Yeah. If you got an auntie or uncle alive, tell them that you love them. Amen. Family is very important. Family is very important. So you do what you can while you can. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. All these things happen within the frameworks of time. But God is everlasting. He's an everlasting God. God made time so we could live in it. Amen. So that we could function in it. So that we could do things in it within time. But God is everlasting. He's an everlasting God. Yeah. That's why he says, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. That's what Deacon Hawkins is. And that's what he is. And he wouldn't want to come back to this mean and cruel world that we're living in. It's messed up. Yeah. If you're black, it's really messed up because folks don't like you no way. Amen, somebody. Yeah. So he wouldn't come back. Even if he could, he's in a place where it's described heaven as streets that's made of gold. He's walking on the streets of gold. Amen. He's with Jesus. No more sickness. No more deaths. His enemies can't follow him where he's gone. Amen. Every day is like Sunday, and Sabbath has no end. Every day. A time to weep. Bible says, and a time to laugh. A time to moan and a time to dance. But I want to encourage the family and let you know today that weeping might endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Trouble don't last always. This too shall pass. Amen. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. A time to cast away and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time. Time for all of this. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understanding. Because God don't make no mistakes. Yeah. But he said, I'll be with you even until the end of the world. God will be there. Even until the end of the world. Yes, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. My brothers and my sisters, we all can say together that God let us know that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your hearts that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Amen, somebody. Thou shalt be saved. So let us not walk away from here today thinking in our hearts that Deacon Hawkins is dead, for his soul is with the Lord. Amen. We'll live on forever with the Lord. the rich man. The Bible tells me that's story of the rich man. The rich man and Lazarus. The rich man died. All of us gonna have to leave this world. The rich man died, and in hell he lifted up his eyes. Then poor Lazarus, didn't he? Lazarus died. And the angels came and placed him in Abraham's bosom. So when we transition, amen, when we leave this world, we go to a better place. To a better place. Oh, dear family, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in Jesus. For in our Father's house are many mansions. Do what you can. That you can't do, let God do it. But do what you can do and give the rest to the Lord. Amen and amen.
We bear all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. The family of the late Deacon John Henry Hawkins would like to take this opportunity to say thank you for all acts of kindness shown to them during this, their hour of bereavement. They do ask that you continue to pray for them and their strength in the days to come. Resolution that was sent to the family. Antioch Baptist Church, 1175 Bankers Road, Pineview, Georgia. Dr. James E. Jimmerson, pastor. Resolution for Deacon John Hawkins. I am on the battlefield for my Lord, and I promised him that I would serve him until I die. Whereas it has pleased the Almighty God to call from this earthly labor to spiritual rest the soul of our deceased brother, Deacon John Hawkins. We hereby resolve that he had the quality of spirit to work here on earth and will be inspired by the hope of heaven. We further resolve that John Hawkins served as a deacon of the Antioch Baptist Church. In this capacity, he rendered unto the Lord hymns, prayers, served on the deacon board, and in addition, he assisted wherever needed to include ushering, finance, building committee, and cleaning of the church. Deacon Hawkins shall forever be remembered by his strong dedication to stand before the congregation and uplift his voice singing, "We are climbing Jacob's ladder and everything is moving by the power of God." We further resolve that we shall remember Deacon Hawkins' kind, soft-spoken words and strong sense of dedication and devotion to his Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Deacon Hawkins' love for his family was so deeply cherished. The undivided love for his devoted wife, Geraldine, was a gift of love and beautiful happiness given by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He took a rib from Adam's side because he saw that man was lonely, and he blessed Deacon Hawkins with the love of his life. Be it resolved that we shall forever be grateful and indebted to the memory of Deacon John Hawkins because he shared his time, interest, and means, both spiritually and faithfully, to ensure that the mission of the church was fulfilled. We shall continue to miss his soft-spoken sense of humor and kind words of encouragement. We further resolve that a copy of this resolution be kept in the files of our records and one given to the family with love, respect, and deep sympathy. On this day of our Lord, February 7th, 2021. Signed, Dr. James E. Jimmerson, pastor, and Sister Renee Martin, secretary. The following plants and arrangements were given to the family with love. With deepest sympathy, Dr. James E. Jimmerson, pastor at the Antioch Baptist Church family of Pineview, Georgia. With deepest sympathy, Charlie Lassiter, Shanetta Lassiter, and Jay Biss. With deepest sympathy, the family of the Mays, Pastor Ernest Mays, Betty Mays, Shirley Mays, Jeanette Mays, Jeanetta Statham, and Precious Faith Church, Pastor Mays. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, and the staff of the J.W. Williams Funeral Home, we would like to present to this family an African-American heirloom Bible. It is our prayer that during this time you find words of encouragement through the Bible. For scripture tells us that the weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning. The J.W. Williams Funeral Home is also pleased to present to this family a pictorial tribute of the life of your loved one in order that you may have happy memories of him in the days to come.
This I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither do corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We all shall not sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. And we shall be changed. While this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. But when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall come to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy victory? O death, where is thy sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Wherefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. My friends, whereas death has once more invaded our ranks and removed from the walk of life our dear brother, John Hawkins, his soul having departed to dwell in the undiscovered country from whose born no man returns, it has become our sad duty to commit his body to the grave. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And our inspired privilege to commend his soul to our Maker, Father, and Redeemer in the confident hope of the coming again of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the resurrection of the body from the grave, and the joyous life reserved for the children of light in the realm of glory. Let us pray. Oh God, have mercy upon us. Go with this family. Comfort them like only you can. Be with them as they go through the next days and weeks and months and years. For you are a company keeper. You're a heart fixer, you're a mind regulator. Bless his children. Bless his wife. Bless his sisters. Oh God, have mercy upon them. Be with them, oh God, as they run this race, that the running may not be in vain. Have mercy, God. Bless, I pray, oh God, everybody that's here today. Keep us as we depart from this place, but not your presence. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the love of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth and forevermore. Let the church say amen.